Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bruno from the BTN HD. And yes, we're doing a hands-on today with the Lenovo ThinkPad X1 tablet. This tablet was actually introduced at this year's CES at Las Vegas. I gave you guys a quick glimpse when I was down there, but I finally got a review unit. And let's get down into the hands-on. Here are the specifications for the ThinkPad X1 tablet. Now, this particular model is running a 1.10 GHz Intel Core M5 processor. For graphics, it's running an Intel HD 515. It has 8 gigs LPWDR3 memory embedded into the motherboard. It has a beautiful 12-inch Gorilla Glass 4 display. The resolution is 2160 by 1140. For storage, it has 256 gigs of solid-state drive. The front camera has 2 megapixels with fixed focus, and the rear camera has 8 megapixels with autofocus and a flash LED. One of the things I like about this tablet, it has TMP, which is its Trusted Platform Module 2.0 for security. For IT professional, it has the Intel vPro technology to manage remotely. It has Windows 10 Pro 64. It weighs about 1.69 plus pounds. So let's take a closer look at the X1 tablet. So if you have the tablet face down and you're able to open up the keyboard case like this, on your right hand side, let's turn it and see what type of ports it has. So the first port right here, this is your Type-C USB port. This one is a USB 3.0. This is your speaker and a mini display port. Let's turn it the other way. And this right here is your hybrid port, which allows you to hook up your headphone as well as a mic system. Your volume control, another speaker, and this port right here is to lock it down. And if you look at the front, this is the power button. This is where you turn it on. And one of the cool things about the X1 tablet from Lenovo is it comes with an awesome pen. Now, this is an active pen with 2048 levels of pressure sensitivity, which is awesome. It's battery powered, so it's not Bluetooth. So that means you actually have to purchase a battery to get it up and running. You're able to customize the buttons right here for your left and right click. With the active pen, you're also going to get yourself an awesome keyboard. Now, this keyboard is not Bluetooth, so that means you have to hook it up at the bottom base of the tablet. It's magnetic, and I love the keyboard. The keyboard feels just like the original laptop keyboards. The spacing between all the keys are great, that I'm not hitting the wrong key when I'm writing, which is awesome. It has a signature nice little red little dot right there to control the mouse. The mouse pad is great. Sometimes it lags a little bit. The keyboard doesn't come with any additional ports, so that means it doesn't have like an extra USB port. It's just a keyboard. You plug it in, you use it automatically, it reads it, and you start using it, you know, which is pretty awesome. Now, hooking up the tablet to the keyboard is extremely easy. This is the base right here, as you guys can see. This is all magnetic. Now, these little grids right here is what connects to this little base right here. So if you just take it and just, there you go, it's automatically gonna attach to itself. And then you guys are able to use it with no problem. All right. Now, to stand it up, at the back of the tablet, there is a stand. There is a switch right here in the back that pops it out, and then you're able to adjust it. Now, this is the farthest that you could go. So this is goes here. And then you're able to bring it down further down until it closes. I did notice that at the very back inside the stand, there is a micro SD slot right here, which is pretty awesome. One cool thing about this device is that it has a fingerprint reader, which is pretty cool. So that means you can either use the camera, your 4-digit PIN, a regular password, or your fingerprint scanner right here to log in into Windows 10. Now, tablets are great to use, especially if you're a photographer and like to edit images on the fly. Now, I have some images on the desktop right here. I have about 32. And we are going to do a image process batch within Photoshop. So I have Photoshop up here. And we're going to go to File, Scripts, Image Processor. And we're going to select that folder within our desktop, and it's called Images. We're going to leave it in the same location. I'm going to give it the quality of 12, and I'm going to run an action. So I want to run the action of color quadrants or quadrant colors, which is my favorite. I'm going to start my timer right here. Here's my timer. And we're going to see how fast all these 32 images are rendered within this machine. So let's click on run and start. So it looks like it's done. It took about 2 minutes and 21 seconds, or maybe 2 minutes and 25 seconds. This tablet is capable of doing image processing. Again, I really think tablets are great for photographers when you guys need to edit things on the fly, especially if you use the Active Pen that it comes with, which is an awesome addition. So you guys saw a little bit of the image processing. It took about 2 minutes and 30 seconds or so to process 32 images into a quadrant color run action within Photoshop. Now, I ran some benchmarks programs within this tablet. I ran Geekbench, PC Mark, and as well as 3D Mark. The only reason why I ran 3D Mark is because I wanted to see how well it runs with gaming. It doesn't have like a high-end graphics processor. Again, it's only running an Intel HD 515 processor, so you can't really run intensive games. So in Geekbench, as a 64-bit run, it actually gave it a single core of 2813 score. For multi-core, it gave it 5057. For 32-bit, 2577 for a single core. And for multi-core, 4844. Now for PC Mark, I did a home, work, and creativity. The highest that you could get for frames per second playing games with this tablet is only 20.7 frames per second. The overall performance on benchmark for home gave it 2160. Now for battery, because all of us users love to know how long will it last battery-wise. Now for home, I basically went online, checking out stuff, opening stuff, copying stuff over, editing some files, playing a little bit of game. Now the gaming within the battery life only got up to 17.3 frames per second, which is really low. That means you guys cannot play Grand Theft Auto on this tablet. The battery life was about 3 hours and 56 minutes. Now for the work, it gave it a score of 2534. The benchmark for the battery for work environment took 4 hours, but it really depends on how you guys use it. I think you could probably stretch it to 5 hours, but again, with the testing and the benchmark stuff, it only lasts about 4 hours. Now for the storage benchmark results, again, it is running a 256 solid state drive. The way that PC Mark tests out the storage is it runs World of Warcraft, Battlefield, I do a little bit of light Photoshop stuff like editing, opening up the file. Heavy Photoshop is creating high intense JPEGs, adding filters, converting them down, cropping them. InDesign is the same thing. The numbers are there. I think the tablet works great for home office usage. It gave it a score of 4955, which is extremely high. The storage speed is there is 242.76 megabytes per second, which is awesome. Now for the graphics processor, I was only able to run two tests within 3D Mark, and the scores weren't that high. For Skydiver, it gave it a score of 2506, and it beat a machine, an office PC with an AMD processor, which is not that bad, but it couldn't beat a notebook that was running a GTX GeForce. For the CloudGate, again, it kind of beat the Office PC, but it wasn't able to handle the Intel Core i7 processor that was running a GeForce 840M. So this, I don't really recommend this tablet for a gaming PC at all. Okay, so let's test out the Action Pen. Again, this Action Pen has 2048 pressure sensitivity. So that means it's really accurate, right? So let's test it out. So with the tablet, with the X1 tablet, Lenovo actually hooks you up with a app called Write It. And this app is pretty awesome. So let's just start going. Like, wow, that's pretty cool. I don't know, let's, I mean, it's pretty accurate. Look at that, it's pretty cool. Look at that, that's pretty cool. One of the things I love about the tablet is that you're able to put your hand onto the, see, as you can, put your hand, put your fist. You put your fist and you're able to write. So if I could clear this out, let me delete that. And let's say if I put my hand on top of it, like I'm writing something, it's still doing it. But you don't see any smudge or marks there, which is awesome. I love that technology. The pen is really cool. So clicking on this little guy and you're able to, gives you a nice little circle. Oh, cool, so let's test out this. This is the highlighter, eraser. Cool, there's a little delay with the eraser, which is okay. Oh, there's a huge delay with the eraser. I'm over here erasing and I can't erase it. Let's try that one more time. And let's erase it. Oh, okay, cool. Oh, cool, look at that. You're able to adjust the way it is. So if I'm able to do this, I'm able to draw. This is great for presentation, especially if you're an individual that like to travel and you present things to clients. This is great. You know, you project it on a huge projector using the mini display port. You could do it HDMI or VGA or DVI, and then you could just basically write on your presentation and just basically say, hey, this is here, this is there. This is a great thing. So how fast does the X1 tablet from Lenovo boot up, right? It is running a 256 solid state drive. It does have 8 gigs of memory embedded inside the motherboard. So I have my nice little stopwatch right here. I'm gonna press start and powered it on to see how fast it actually loads to the desktop. All right, so it took about 22 seconds. Whoa, that's pretty high for a tablet. Super surprised that this tablet boots up to 22 seconds. Wow, that's pretty weird, right? All right, guys, so that concludes our hands-on with Lenovo's ThinkPad X1 tablet. I mean, overall, it's a great tablet. I love the fact that it comes with the Active Pen, which is a plus. It also comes with the keyboard. I do like the fact that Lenovo is expanding this tablet to extend its ability, meaning they have like a module to add to it, to give it a 3D RealSense camera, which is awesome. Another module to extend the battery to 5 hours plus, and to also give you extra ports, like another HDMI, two more additional 3.0 USB ports, which that's cool. And I think the last projector that they're supposed to be coming out is one to, like a projector. Like you're able to hook it up and then project whatever you have on the tablet, which is awesome, because especially if you take this tablet to a client and you forgot your cable, but you have the module, just hook up the module and then display it on the wall and then you're good to go. I'm a little disappointed that it only has one USB 3.0 port. It'd been awesome if it was another additional one on the other side, but you know what? Can't complain about it. Super surprised of the boot time. It took about, what, 22 seconds or 25 seconds to boot to the desktop. Not too happy about that. But overall, it's a great tablet. I don't recommend it to be used for gaming. It's not a gaming machine. The highest that you go with the frame per second is between 17.5 to 20 frames per second. You cannot go higher than that or you're going to destroy the machine. Or it's going to overheat really fast or lag extremely bad for you. It is running an Intel Core M5 processor. And for the GPU, it is running an Intel HD 515, I believe it is. It's not really classified for a gaming system. I do love the cameras. The camera in the back panel does have an LED indicator, like a nice little flash indicator, which is cool. I love the fact that this has TPM, which is Trusted Platform Module for security things. This is great for us IT admins that deploy this stuff to our users. And it also has vPro Intel, so we could actually manage remotely, which is a plus for us. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this hands-on with Lenovo's ThinkPad X1 tablet. Leave comments right below. Don't forget about hitting that like button, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.